What's going on, everyone? It's late. It is late. As you guys can see on my gaming rig, we have Call of Duty Warzone. Now, this is the primary Call of Duty game that I play. I have yet to purchase Call of Duty Modern Warfare nor Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. I've always been a fan of Call of Duty storyline. It's just that since they've released the Call of Duty Warzone, I've just been addicted that I just haven't gotten around to trying out Modern Warfare or Black Ops Cold War. That's honestly it. I have did the tryout for Call of Duty Black Ops. I like it. Which was the tryout of basically the multiplayer, which is cool. Love Nuketown. That's nonetheless, let's get to the story. So guys, what I have here is my Xbox One controller. This is basically an Amazon Basics Xbox One wired controller. If you guys can kind of see that. This is the controller that I basically play my Call of Duty game on and other games on. I absolutely love it. Just love the way it feels, love the way it games. It's wonderful. Before, I was playing on a keyboard. As you guys can kind of see, the keyboard is lighting up here. It was different. It's a different experience because I'm used to console gaming. With console, you're typically gaming with a controller. So then when I went to PC environment of gaming, I didn't necessarily have an actual controller. So once I purchased the controller, then I was like, okay, cool. Now I can play Call of Duty with a controller. But then I was like, controller's not even working. So that's when I, you know, discovered that you gotta enable the controller option in order for you to be able to use it. So right here down at the bottom left, there's an option that says options. That's quite interesting. There's an options that says options. So now what you want to do is you want to go over to, and these are all for everybody that just first getting started with basically utilizing a controller. So that way you can enable the movement and all. So you'll select general, okay? Now by default, basically have keyboard and mouse highlighted. When you're playing a game, you're moving around with your keyboard or mouse. So what you want to do is you want to select controller, and now you can see that's highlighted or underlined, and basically that's now going to allow the controller to be used for your movement, shooting, and other movements. Okay, so now that we have our controller enabled, now what we're going to do is we're going to actually modify some settings for the controller so that we can get the best utilization of using a controller, which, trust me, there is a benefit playing Call of Duty Warzone from the PC and utilizing a controller. You guys want to get those precise aiming movement so that way it can help increase your kill to death ratio, be able to spank people in these games. Man, you need to modify your controller settings. Don't go with the standard. Go with some modified settings. The first thing that you want to change is your button layout. You want to change this from default to tactical, okay? Default to tactical. I highly recommend that you guys practice, you know, do a round, practice, get a good feel of it. But trust me, you'll love it. All right, so we just change that to tactical. All right, so what you're going to do is change your dead zone to 0.05, okay? Again, these are settings that I use. You can play around with it and see if it's something that you can feel as though that it will help you. Guarantee you, after you start to play around with it, it will help you indeed. We got the horizon stick sensitivity set to 4, vertical stick sensitivity set to 4, okay? For both of the low and high zoom, you want to set that to 0.70. So for aim, we're going to keep that as standard. Controller vibration, it's up to your preference. I have it on. Some people, they don't like it on. It's all on your preference. Aim assist, you want to keep that as standard. Now, if you basically modify it for precision or focusing or anything of that nature, it's basically going to override your settings, okay? Other thing is for equipment behavior, you guys want to select that as hold, okay? All right, so for the next option, we want to go over to graphics, and we're going to scroll all the way down, and we're going to disable world motion blur and weapon motion blur, as you guys can see. So probably by default, you guys probably have it enabled. You want to disable both of those options. Okay. And we're going to apply the settings. Now, what we're going to do is go over to audio. Majority of the gamers that are gaming from a computer are gaming and utilizing a headphone, so that way they can have a microphone. You want to adjust your audio mix from studio reference to boost. And the reason being is because boost is actually going to improve the sound of footsteps in shots, so which is very, very, very important, especially if you're like doing sniping. You want to know if there's an enemy nearby while you're, you know, out sniping. You can hear something real more quicker and be able to react to it. Say for instance, you're trying to go to some sort of location, you want to be able to hear if an enemy is nearby, you know, them shooting. You want to be able to hear that and be able to decipher where the enemy location is, so that way you can protect yourself. So that's highly, highly important. Audio mix sets that to boost. So now what we're going to do is give this bad boy a test. While that's loading, you know me, I always got to check on the price of cryptocurrency. That is like my at night thing to do. It's like, how's the price of these cryptocurrency and stocks and bonds? Like, what's going on in the world? And then I also check the news. Like, call me old. Oh, man. I'm looking at stuff for like retirement. That's real.
Friendly UAV overhead. Enemy soldier incoming.
I don't see anybody coming.
Bounty target has been marked. Kill him.
Whoa, what was that?
I'm taking fire. Moving.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
Bounty target is down. Well done. Objective is to eliminate the bounty target. Bounty target is down. Well done. Friendly UAV overhead.
Alright, as long as we stick together.
Primary LZs are marked. Extract is standing by. Objective is to eliminate the bounty target.
Alright. Over here. definitely is running. I think that bounty's kind of too far away, though. Coming back. I don't know where he's at.
Time's up. Objective failed.
Pounded on it.
An enemy team is hunting you. Stay alert. Attack chopper is in the AO. Bring it down and recover the cash.
Another bag. Yes. That's what I need, baby.
Contract updated. New objective identified. Friendly UAV overhead. Enemy soldier incoming.
I gotta head back over there.
Enemy soldier incoming.
Alright, I'm gonna head back to your location. Cause right now I'm surrounded.
Hostile dropping into the area. Moving. Watch the skies. Contract updated. New objective identified.
Target bomb! Send it!
This is Striker 3-1. Good copy. Strike it.
You evaded the enemy trackers. Good work.
much odds missed?
Troops in contact.
Primary objective accomplished. All supply boxes found. You've collected 1 million. All cash has been deposited. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies.
All right, let's do it.
Striker 3-1, good copy. Strike inbound. Impact destroyed.
Friendly UAV overhead.
Come on, baby.
Be advised, friendly precision airstrike inbound. Friendly UAV overhead.
Oh man, we are killing it, baby.
Be advised, friendly precision airstrike inbound.
Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Just fuck. God damn, that was a nice one. I got some more cash for y'all.
You made it through and took the win. Well done.
Yes, sir. Came in with that win, baby. The win of the night. Appreciate it, guys. You guys did an awesome job. Good game, baby. I can't say much. I'm tired. So yeah, guys, give this a shot. Check out the settings. See if this will help you. And no doubt, you'll see a difference. You'll definitely see a difference, but you'll more than likely have to get adjusted with the new settings. But you know, give it a couple of rounds. I think Plunder will be the best way for you to actually get the full experience, since you know, Battle Royale and was it Rebirth Island, they're pretty much like kind of short when it comes to gameplay. So with Plunder, you can respawn, which gives you another shot at trying things out. So on that note, guys, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share my videos. Man, I tell you, I got more videos on the way. I don't just do gaming. I do a lot of DIYs, tech tips, home improvement tips, automotive tips. Man, I got so many tips. I'm just here to help you guys. And my channel is all about learning. It's about, you know, troubleshooting issues, finding solutions. And that way we can grow together. Grow together, learn together, be better. Peace.